long country.
This is Sunday Mass with Bishop Greg Homeming.
Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with
your spirit. As we gather for Mass, let's once again try to stand before our loving God in the truth of who we are. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are Son of God and Son of Mary, Christ of mercy. You are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the most in the glory of God the Father. Amen. And let us pray. O God, who manifest your almighty power above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those who hasten to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the prophet Ezekiel. The word of the Lord was addressed to me as follows. You object. What the Lord does is unjust. Listen, you house of Israel. Is what I do unjust? It is not what you do that is unjust. When the upright man renounces his integrity to commit sin and dies because of this, he dies because of the evil that he himself has committed. When the sinner renounces sin to become law-abiding and honest, he deserves to live. He has chosen to renounce all his previous sins. He shall certainly live. He shall not die. The word of the Lord. Remember your mercies, O Lord. Lord, make me know your ways. Lord, teach me your paths. Make me walk in your truth and teach me, for you are God my Saviour. Remember your mercies, O Lord. Remember your mercy, Lord, and the love you have shown from of old. Do not remember the sins of my youth. In your love, remember me. Because of your goodness, O Lord, remember your mercies, O Lord. The Lord is just and upright. He shows the path to all who stray. He guides the humble in the right path. He teaches his way to the poor. Remember your mercies, O Lord.
The second reading is from St. Paul to the Philippians. If our life in Christ means anything to you, if love can persuade at all, or the Spirit that we have in common, or any tenderness and sympathy, then be united in your convictions and united in your love, with a common purpose and a common mind. That is the one thing which would make me completely happy. There must be no competition among you, no conceit, but everybody is to be self-effacing. Always consider the other person to be better than yourself, so that nobody thinks of his own interests first, but everybody thinks of other people's interests instead. In your minds, you must be the same as Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. My sheep listen to my voice, says the Lord. I know them and they follow me. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his chief priests and the elders of the people, "What is your opinion? A man had two sons. He went and said to the first, 'My boy, you go and work in the vineyard today.' He answered, 'I will not go,' but afterwards thought better of it and went. The man then went and said the same thing to the second, who answered, 'Certainly, sir,' but did not go. Which of the two did the father's will?" "The first," they said. Jesus said to them, "I tell you solemnly, tax collectors and prostitutes are making their way into the kingdom of God before you. For John came to you, a pattern of true righteousness, but he did not believe him. And yet the tax collectors and the prostitutes did. Even after seeing that, you refused to think better of it and believe in him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. When I was about 7 or 8 years old, my father told me something that I've never forgotten. In fact, as you get older, once your parents die, you keep remembering what they told you. And he told me this. He said, "Son, when you grow up, always try to work out what the right thing to do is. And once you've worked it out, never let anyone convince you to do other than what you know to be the right thing." I can say to my dad, it doesn't mean I've always done the right thing, but I've always tried to do what he asked me to do. A consequence of which is his brother-in-law, who lives in Sydney, once said to me, "Do you know what your problem is?" And I said, "What?" "You're too good." And I said, "It's not that I'm good, I'm just doing what my father taught me to do. It's what I've tried to do for my whole life. And I pray that I will always try to do that." Today's gospel is a very interesting gospel because it consists of two sons. One who says, "Yes, I will do it," and doesn't. And the other one who says, "No, I won't," and does. Let's try to enter into the guy that says, "No, I won't," but does. What happened in him? Well, to use ordinary vocabulary, his conscience got the better of him. And he, in his own way, worked out what the right thing to do was and followed that rather than what his preference was. Because the simple truth is, there are many things that we should do that we don't want to do. And somehow our conscience gets the better of us. What a gift God has given us in that. It's not something which makes us scrupulous, but it's something which in fact directs us. And he then goes and does what he should do. I think today's gospel is very simple. There needs to be an alignment between my life or your life and what you know to be correct and right. When there is a misalignment, something is going terribly wrong. And not only that, it leads to people who have two personalities, two characters, two ways of doing things. The alignment of the way I am, how I live and what I do with my conscience, I think is what one of the main things which brings about integrity in a person, because there's a certain oneness which is there. When that oneness is broken, then you become, as it were, a person of many facets, and integrity falls apart. And I think today's gospel simply invites us to ponder and see ourselves in today's gospel and find the way to move with integrity to what life really is. And that is, I'm made in such a way that everything fits together. And it fits together, I believe, the way my father taught me. You can work out what's right. Work it out and make sure that what you worked out now directs your life. And I think God is in the working out. And if we follow, we live as God wants us to live. Let's stand and profess our faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Always seeking to do the will of God, let us bring our prayers to our Heavenly Father.
For a spirit of penitence in all members of the Catholic Church. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders, that they cooperate generously to manage the world's resources sustainably, prevent degradation of the environment, protect threatened species, and safeguard vulnerable people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the conversion of men and women enmeshed in lives of crime and vice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For respect and care for God's creation in the natural environment. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sick and bereaved, that they may receive healing and acceptance through Christ and the intercession of St. Mary of the Cross and Venerable Nano Nagel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the blessed dead, both those recently deceased and those whose anniversary is at this time. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we make these and all our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Praise of God. Lord your God.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Grant us, O merciful God, that this our offering may find acceptance with you, and through that it will be a wellspring of all blessing which may be laid upon us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being, and while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Holy, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." And in a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, me your unworthy servant, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, Saint Teresa, Saint John of the Cross, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Thy kingdom come, and will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God.
Take away the sins of the world, bless us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, bless us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world,
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, don't run to my room. This heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be co-heirs in glory with Christ, to whose suffering we are united whenever we proclaim his death, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Go with the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
We are good.